Hello, everyone, and I actually decided to start keeping track of these things. Hooray! So now we can cap. Oh, come on. Oh. That's really bad, actually. What the hell are these things? Well, you know how I said it wasn't gonna put a door on here? I'm gonna put a door on there. Like right now, please. Didn't attack you? Now they did. Everyone in here now. Got a situation. Janitor Mailer is in front, please. Cola, go get a pitchfork. Crow, you're always useless. What are you doing, Ryuki? Ryuki? Ryuki, we're dealing with a problem here. Okay, that's one dead. What's the damage like? What have we dealt with? That's bad. Might as well go take care of the other one. Mailer up front. Let's get everyone right here. With guns. Okay, they're dead. Those were crazy. That could have been really bad. You know what? I'm gonna cancel that door. We don't need a door there. Doors? What do you need doors for? No, what we need to do, well, after that, thank you everyone for witnessing that, we're going to start building this. Hopefully no one dies. We are low on food, apparently, that's what the game says, but I don't think we are. So what do we butcher from those? Just leather. Koala, you can stop that. So just 48 chitin. Okay. We did gather the components from there. Yeah, we did. So we got quite a few components. We are researching. Honey is researching. When she's not injured. A lot of blood in here. So yes, they are working on this. Cat is pregnant again. Awesome. Oh no. Well, those two are basically dead, so the chance of us curing them of the plague is highly a no, a big no. So They're dead. So we're down to one muffalo. Sadly. They're working hard on this. Very good. Honey decided to go for that same corpse, different corpse, and just sit on the ground. That's nice for you. Decided to go resting. I know you're the last of your brethren. Sad. You only have one more muffalo. The other ones all died. The other first ones died of starvation due to the harsh winter. Almost, all the others. And then these two died of the plague, basically, because there was no way we were going to save them from that. We don't have good enough medicine for that. Sad, I know, but it's what happens. Let's try getting as much crops growing. We're definitely nowhere near the amount of food we had before, which I find kind of silly. I mean, yeah, we have a few more mouths to feed, but we're growing a lot more food in comparison to before. It's weird. If we get the water mill generators, we can... What has happened to the water? What happened to my water graphics? Oh, I just noticed that. My water graphics are all messed up for some reason. Generally supposed to have like rushing like look to it. Instead it's just glitching out. I don't know why that's happening. Don't know how long that's been happening. I'll have to go over the videos. That's crazy. Another meteorite of silver. Well, we're kind of focusing on this right now. Safety. So, especially, we'll be completely safe once we get the water mill generator going. A couple water mill generators right here going along this river, which will be fantastic. And then we can really start focusing on some really crazy things. Dirty cooking area. Yes, I know. I'm gonna put you to cleaning too. That way, home will always be clean. Except, I really hate when they clean this, honestly. See, they love to clean the tunnel here, which I'm just like, okay, would not be generally a problem. Except for the fact that it is a problem, because then they'll want to clean the traps, and then they'll just do it at random at times, and it's really annoying. Same with out here. Like, if you don't do this, they'll run out of your fortress, of the base you made, out probably during a raid or something, and try to clean out here. It's like, really? It's so stupid. Yeah, I know. All the rice in here, that's fine. Don't replant this right now. The rice in there, we don't need right now. Everything else we need right now. So yeah, everything is going well. Everything's going really well, actually. The traps are half done, as you can see. They're coming along. We're also going to have to put a floor to them, sadly. Just going to use up even more wood. That sucks. Because these trees also mess with the pathfinding. So we're going to have to do that. Yeah, sadly. Now, I'm going to order more trees to be chopped down. Like, definitely these ones right here. Some here. Any trees inside need to be chopped down. That can be chopped down yet. And these trees, and these trees, and these trees. Yep. Low food, yeah. Honey's going around cleaning everything and then she'll go back to researching, that's fine. I should technically strip Crystal, because that armor, the stuff she's wearing does give her some protection from if she tries to break out and whatnot, she'll be at least a little defended. Terrible room to do that, because then it could have really cooked this room up and made these meals spoil. And once again, she's cleaning the house, which had been needed to be done for a long time now. Of course, another binge. Not like things are worse enough, huh? How goes it down here? It's going slowly, but well. They're working on it. Once that's built, everything will be a lot better. Ugh. Stretch! Alright. Power's out again. Black. Can't get on that. Thanks. And Ryuki. Actually, let's not get that. Let's get this. These two. Let's not refuel this one. I actually kind of want to destroy this, tear this one down. Especially because it's in this room. And it's messing with the cooling. Crow, where are you? Black, there you are. Crow's sleeping away, doing nothing much at all. Yes, it's starting to look good. Starting to go good well. It's going very well. Bandit camp. Well, we're not going to deal with that. We did save one person, Beatrice, but that's already proven to have been kind of a bite in our butt because we lost 33 components, like 32, 33. We lost 38 or something like that. We lost a buttload. That pissed me off. So I don't exactly feel like saving more people and doing stuff out there for now. And yeah, without all the muffalo, we can't really go out and about for sure and carry a lot of stuff, like food and whatnot, without having survival package meals, and that stuff is very hard to make. I mean, clearly it's like down here. Yeah, it's right down here. So it's quite a ways. We got power working again for the coolers. Yeah, and when we need the heat, we'll just turn off these, and just have this going throughout the base. So they're working hard down there. Honey, are you done cleaning? Nope. Ugh. Honey's cleaning Oh my gosh, why you do this to me? See what I mean? Okay, I'm gonna turn you back off from cleaning because I need you to focus on number one, research. Another saving quest. We're right here, she's over here. Days, we'll think about it. We will think about it. That we might be able to do. I want to first see how much food we can get in here, because right now we have none. Really, like none. This is almost built, finished, which is looking very nice. A nice little trap compartment thing going on. This will defend us against most normal attacks at our current size. Which is all we need. Oh, and it'll keep out bears and whatnot from attacking livestock that we have roaming around out here. Which is great. And then I can focus on expanding again, actually getting some bedrooms going. Yeah, right now we just live in a barracks. But maybe actually get like a bedroom system going on. It's speaking to me. I don't like it. Ooh, alpacas! Any muffalo? No. Just a bunch of boomalopes. Oh, a bunch of boomalopes. That would be kind of nice if we were going for the biofuel generators. But I'm not. I'm going for water. Water generator. And then later, thermal. Geothermal. The power of the base. We're not going to be that reliant on power anyway, either. For defenses, this is all we really need. Yeah, like sieges and whatnot, this is all you need. Just expand this down all the way around here. Yeah, it'll just be like 100 traps, just killing everything. Then we just need like a giant tree farm for wood to feed that thing. And that'd be it. Where we'd be safe for life, really. Growing the hay grass now, so that animals will have food during winter. I might as well put hay in here. And kibble. For now. So they won't spoil until, you know, until we need to move them over here during winter. We'll move them back in there, so because then animals will be staying in there. Okay, I'm gonna turn off the cutting of these trees because that's just way too far away. Out of the way, we don't need out of the way. We need in the way cutting. Plenty of wood. Let's haul these out. They're in the way of this glorious contraption we have built. It's almost complete, and you get an idea. It's basically, it's a whole bunch, it's 47 traps that they're just gonna be activating. So they're gonna get through 47 spike traps to get to our base, to get inside at least. That's the goal, and because it's technically not that hard, it's technically a straight way in. AI are just going to prefer to go through this unless they're sappers. If it's sappers, we're kind of screwed, no matter what. And again, that's why I kind of hope to build a like a little defense right here. Like a front door defense, maybe right here to prevent that for issue. There we go, we have officially completed except for this one little piece of wood floor. But we officially completed... Okay, really? Just complete it. There we go. It's officially complete and ready. Once we move the stones, just for ease of speed, it is completely ready to be used as a trap. It's ready. So colonists will want to go through all these doors right here, but AI enemies and animals would want to go through the zigzag, which would hurt them a lot. Yes, it's a bit slower to get through all this, but it's safe, is the thing. And whenever, like, hey, I need to rearm this trap right here, well, the AI, our guys, will go through these doors and rearm it, and so on and so forth. It's very nice. Crow's really trying to recruit Crystal. And we almost got that done. It's very nice. You know what? This has been a 21-minute episode already. I'm going to end it here. Well, the trap is ready. Stay prototype 1. Now, ways you can expand this is by going wider and longer and making it more deadly that way. And basically, this is going to be your main defense of your base. Eventually, you can get more crafty with, like, landmines, whatnot, that you can do. Turrets. A lot of people just go with the turret idea, like set up sandbags and just turrets and create a funnel, basically, for them. My favorite, though, is this. This is my favorite. Yes, it uses a buttload of resources because you have to refill these all the time. You have to mess with everything all the time, and it's so much wood. But it's such an easy way to deal damage without worrying about getting a colonist to get an infection and die. So anyway, it's the end of this episode. Thank you for joining me. I'm going to try to keep these between less than 25 minutes is the hope. So yeah. So you can sit down, watch these, and have a good time. Anyway, thank you for watching. Leave a like. That's always nice. Maybe sub. That's also nice. And I'll see you in the next one. Have a good night and a good day and a good life. Bye-bye.